Hey everybody, it's Drogith here, and I'm giving you a kind of a weird replay. coMaBlack sent me these. Oh God, like 2 months ago. I'm bad. I know it. Anyways, he sent me some replays where it was a 1-1-1 build for Protoss, not Terran. Not that the trips Terran build, you know, where it goes Rax to factory to starport, but for Protoss. So I was kind of curious what it was going to be like. He's apparently a diamond, at the time it was diamond 1200 or diamond 1100 going against 1200, something of that sort. But anyway, we're on Desert Oasis and he's playing against Reef. Or, well, actually his opponents might have been 1200, 1100. I don't remember. I'm going to have to go back and check the email in a second. But what we're really going to focus on is coMaBlack's build. As you can see right now, looking at the income tab really quick, so he's got 10. He's just pumping out probes, no gas whatsoever. He did get that pylon at about 9-10 and continued to pump out probes. Pylon is complete and he's still pumping out probes, finally putting a gateway down at 13. Pretty standard build right off the bat. Gateway, I'd say, is a little bit late, though you're on Desert Oasis, so you're not expecting an early rush, unless you're getting proxy barracks. Gas going down at 13 as well, so it looks like, oh, okay, he got the early minerals, went right for that. Let's see, put that guy in queue, put a second guy in queue, and there's the gas, and here's another pylon coming down, so yeah, it's pretty standard build. 13 gateway, and then 13-14 assimilator somewhere around there, and 1-2, yep, 3 probes right on that right away. And apparently this build is really good against early Banshee harass, or eliminating Banshee harass altogether, and dealing with just any type of overall rush against Terran, just because it adds to your adaptability. Now, Reef is falling behind. What is he doing? Factory in the back. Okay, so scouting factory. And it looks like this... Excuse me, the second gas went down. So we're working off of 2 gases for coMaBlack at about 20. Yeah, I'd say 20 just because he finished that up. But he's got an SCV right here. I do not believe the Cybercore counts as part of the 1-1-1 build. But 3 probes directly onto that gas. Look at that, 21-17 on resources. If there was a marine rush, this would really hurt very bad. But the pylon's coming down, and we're just waiting. Waiting. Again, this was in patch 1-1-1, something like that, so we've got a single stalker coming out, not really going to affect the build that much. No other barracks. What is going on this side? Do we have... Okay, we got the engineering bay. We've got engineering bay turrets and whatnot. So we have a robo facility. So here's gateway robo facility. So we've got 1-1 Cybercore again. Does not count. More chrono boosting going on. Some crazy stuff. And look at that, a Stargate. So here's the 1-1-1 build. We have a gateway, robotics facility, and then a Stargate. Now, a nice combination that I can see of these units set up is, obviously, you know, the gateway units, very nice to have, zealots, stalkers, sentries, and whatnot. Nothing really added when you go robotics facility and Stargate. However, if you take, say, a Phoenix, maybe mix it with some stalkers, that'd be a good combination. Observer coming out, just because. That would be a good combination, you know, lift up, stalkers go boom. Very nice to do. I'm not really sure of any other combos that can be pulled out, but you can see a Phoenix. Okay, a Phoenix is coming out right away. We do have a starport. Did we have... Yes, we did have that Trips Terran build on the other side of the board. So that's what's going on over there. And we have actually have another observer coming out. Check the unit tab really quick. Nope, that's... Yeah, there's already one observer out. And the second one's coming out. Look, it's still heavy, heavy probe production. It looks like coMaBlack should actually be expanding soon. But we do have the observers coming over. One observer over there. Here's a phoenix just coming into middle, getting some good sight. Let me check this real quick. Okay, so this was right after destructible rocks. And two sentries and a zealot. Not really much going on. But we are pretty heavy with the phoenixes. Phoenixes for the anti-air right now, and this observer is actually seeing that. You know, it looks like a hellion drop is going to be going on. But yeah, again, nope, gateway actually canceled by coMaBlack. And it does look like a pretty solid build. I mean, you've got sort of just enough units to defend. I would like to see a sentry over here just so that you can block the ramp in case you need to. Or double block some type of vision over here. An expansion is going down at 51 at about 8 minutes in. So 51 food at about 8 minutes in. That's pretty good. Oh, here we got the medevac dropship. I want to see what these two phoenixes are going to do to this guy. Yay, completely miss him. Are the phoenixes going to get out in time? Look at that, phoenixes. Okay, two of the hellions go down. Do any of them get lifted? No. And they do have the blue flame, so that's pretty nasty. But you got that void ray back here for defense. Not too bad. Ooh, probes, what are you doing? Oh, that was ugly. 11 kills by that guy. That was amazing. But yeah, okay, you know, you have the phoenixes. Phoenixes could have done better as far as the attack and defense goes. Let's see. Couple Vikings coming out. Sorry about the yawn. It's been a long day. But the Phoenix is coming over. Let's see. So you've got the double Viking coming out. You got the Void Ray to boot. So the Void Ray is going to be able to charge up. Missile turret on the back over here, seeing the observer. And again, it looks like, you know, Void Ray is going to charge up. Going to have plenty of charge for those Vikings. And will they melt it away? No, the Phoenix is, nope, not going to come in waiting for reinforcements. Oh, silly Vikings. Coming over, taking pop shots. But it looks like we have kind of a, let's see, four Vikings. And we can now get, where's that tech lab? Okay, there is a tech lab on there. So we can get Thors out now. So four Vikings, a couple Marauders, a couple Marines over here, and in the same instance, we have more gateways coming down as support units, three Phoenixes and a Void Ray. So yeah, I can see where the 1-1-1 build for Protoss can be effective. Robotics Bay really isn't adding anything to it. I think it's just for the observers at this point in time. But scan going down, units moving over, expansion is known, and these Vikings will drop, doing an amazing 11 damage per volley. But they can take out probes pretty quickly if there's no upgrade on those probes. Phoenix is coming in. This is always funny to see. Oh, I thought we were going to see a Viking get lifted up and then shot down by a Phoenix. But Phoenix is actually do some very nice damage to Vikings. Even when they're not upgraded, they have a quicker shot. Zealot and Stalker Rush. So you can see, I can see where a nice little counter where the air units, the Phoenixes and the Void Rays, forced Reef to focus on an air or an anti-air kind of build, where he went for the Thor, which is, you know, is very good for anti-air, that great splash damage against the Phoenixes. As well as several Vikings, of which the Vikings died. Those Stalkers are going to die. But coming up right behind them is a nice amount of Zealots. They don't have charge, but they're just going to run right into these infantry guys, get a nice... Didn't really surround yet, but what are the Void Rays? Void Rays came right into the base. Phoenix is coming over. You can't lift up the Thor with the Phoenixes. But so a little bit of harass. Vikings actually making it all the way into the base. Not going to do anything on the Thor. And it looks like we have just some Marauders going on. And still nothing else coming out of the robotics facility. Just the observers. And this one actually just kind of sitting here. Defense against Banshees, I'm going to go for. Proxy Pylon, yep. Warp Gates, yep. And do we have a drop over here? by the Vikings? No, we do not. It's just so that these infantry units can come in. I just leaked on my keyboard. That was disgusting. Phoenix is flying around. Will they come back for the Thors? Gonna take a couple up shots? No, actually, I can't remember if these guys can actually shoot the Thors, the Phoenixes, just because Thors are, you know, big guys. What do they call those? Extremely large units. No, that's what they call my pants. Bazinga. Yeah, you know mine. So again, focusing on the Phoenixes. Not too bad. I don't like that there's no real support from the robotics facility. There's plenty of minerals for it. And, ooh, that hurt. Yeah, there's plenty of minerals for some robotic, some immortals, or even teching up to the Colossus, but I guess that wouldn't really be the 1-1-1 build. For Protoss, if he did that, it'd be like the 1-1-1-1. But yeah, here we got some units. Are we going to see some shields? Maybe a couple force fields splitting up? Nope, these guys stimmed up, charge, running around, just trying to get away, and the Thors are actually going to soak up some of the damage. But then Void Ray, nice job. Void Ray targeting onto that Thor. Thor not really getting any targeting at all. And the Phoenixes, yep, they're coming over here and they're taking... No, they're just kind of standing there. There we go. Lift. So, okay, looking at the armies. Yeah, I can see the effectiveness of this build. There we go. We do finally have Immortals coming out. But from here, there's really not much else you can do. I mean, Vikings are coming up for the Terran player. I would have opted for the Terran side, nukes. I would have, or not nukes, Ghost with EMPs. That probably would have been the best move, just to, one, eliminate the energy on the Phoenixes so that they couldn't do lift, plus it eliminates shields on all Protoss units. Hello, that Void Ray is butter. The Void Ray is paper anyways. So all you're doing is throwing water on it and then hitting it. That's what the EMP is doing. But yeah, I wonder if this has changed with the patches that went through. Just how effective this could potentially be. It doesn't really seem like this Terran player's doing too well. I mean, he had a lot of time in the early harass. He decided to tech up, you know, doing the 1-1-1 build himself to attack, and he had a failed Hellion drop, and instead of massing a bio ball, which a lot of Terrans fall back to do, so, you know, props for him for, oh, wait a minute, no, I don't really count that as a bio ball, because there's like a Thor and a couple of Vikings in there, but, I'd have to do a little more check into this just to see, you know, how effective this is. No Guardian Shield, look at all that energy. 300 energy, no Guardian Shield, no Force Fields. Ugh, that's disgusting. But I can definitely see some potential here as far as how it is. Again, gonna have to look at... There we go, there's a Guardian Shield. Gonna have to look to see if it's still, if you can still potentially do it with the current patches. Let's see, Void Ray was nerfed... Void Ray Stage 2 might have been nerfed. Or Stage 3, depends on how you look at it. Let's see, Sentries, Gateways were already nerfed by that point in time. Marauders, yeah, so this is probably still extremely viable build. Just as long as you're playing against somebody that's doing a big timing thing. So, I actually have one more game by him, by coMaBlack, that shows the same build, the 1-1-1. So we're gonna check that one out right now.